Let me know if this has ever happened to you, where you have this brilliant idea of an app that you want to build, and all you want to do is run home and start working on it. As you start building it, though, you quickly realize you need a backend or a server in the cloud to really demonstrate the full idea. And so you fire up a browser and start searching. How do you build a backend server for a mobile or web app? Well, it turns out you get over a million search results with all sorts of articles and discussion threads, and it can be overwhelming to figure out how to integrate all of these technologies together. But the good news is that a lot of the complexity is handled for you with Google Cloud Endpoints. It has a straightforward workflow, so you can build a shared backend for your Android, iOS, and web clients. Previously, I was an engineer on the Google Keep team and was exposed to the issues that I'll be talking about today with building a new product with multiple clients accessing a backend. And that's why I want to help you get your service up and running as quickly as possible. On the server, you simply define your API and add Cloud Endpoint annotations. There's an awesome tool to automatically generate the client libraries that you can drop into your respective apps. You implement the client code to call your API and the server-side logic with what to do when the API is called, and then everything else in between is handled by Cloud Endpoints. Over time, your server API will naturally evolve, and that's where Cloud Endpoints can really help reduce those accidental errors because it automatically generates the client libraries for you. When you're ready to release the clients with your latest build, we'll help you handle the upgrade smoothly. Now, this is made possible by API versioning support in Cloud Endpoints. Different API versions can actually coexist, and you can do a gradual stage rollout of these new changes. In this example, new clients can start to talk to the V2 API, while your older clients slowly move over until you deprecate the old V1 API. I also want to note that the backend server that we're talking about is actually running on Google App Engine, which is part of the broader Google Cloud platform. Not only do you get a shared backend for your Android, iOS, and web clients, but you can also take advantage of all the other products and services that are available. With App Engine comes the ability to actually scale very easily. As you get more traffic, Google automatically spins up more App Engine instances for you. And then when the traffic levels off after the peak, we kill off the instances that you don't need anymore. You don't need to trouble yourself with estimating resources needs ahead of time, so it's great. As an added bonus, Cloud Endpoints comes with web management tools, such as this API Explorer, which allows you to interact with all of your API endpoints. As seen here, you can create a request and then see what the response is. If you want a bird's eye overview of how healthy the service is for the actual users out there, on the dashboard you can check graphs with QPS, latency, and error rates. You also have access to the logs if you want more detailed data. But enough about development, what type of impact can Cloud Endpoints really have on your users? Well, users expect the app to be blazing fast without those loading spinners that spin forever. It's not ideal if you have a user halfway across the world and they're trying to hit the server that's located in your basement. Instead, you can take advantage of Google's global infrastructure. We have data centers all over the world, and we can route requests to the appropriate data center quickly. Now, users also care about minimizing network usage, which impacts their bill, as well as they want to minimize battery usage. Therefore, once we serialize the data, we compress it for efficient transfer across the network. Now, we know also users want peace of mind that their data is being kept and transferred as securely as possible. So all of our requests are sent over HTTPS, and we also have OAuth 2 support built in to authenticate and authorize the users to access the appropriate data. So as you can see, Google Cloud Endpoints is a straightforward way for you to build a shared backend for your Android, iOS, and web clients. And if you have that browser still open, you can search for Google Cloud Endpoints now. Or you can use the links here. Next time you have that great idea, now you know what to do.